Well, hello there, folks. This is John Pelham. Kind of referring back to a sermon from Pastor Justin this past weekend in his series, On Earth as It Is in Heaven, where he talked about floods and famine. And I had a couple of personal experiences. Some of you have heard about the great drought, the Texas drought of the 50s. I was living on a small farm in Central Texas during that period of time, and it was one of the most devastating things that ever happened to us. We went from about 1949 to about 1957 with, most places around the state, less than half of the rain we would normally get, and temperatures well exceeding the number of high temperature days that we would normally expect. A lot of people went out of business, a lot of people left and went to do something else. It broke in April of 57 by a terrible, terrible flood. In fact, Lake Whitney was just Brazos River was dammed up by the dam, and there wasn't much water catching, and it filled up within a few days from that flood. Fast forward to several years later, I was working at the University of Missouri in Columbia, Missouri, close to the where the Missouri River bisects the state from northwest to southeast. When the great flood of 1993 came along and flooded most of the areas along and either side of the Mississippi River on the east side of the state, and the Missouri River cut down through the middle of the state. It was a horrible, horrible time. Farmers lost many, many acres of great agricultural land. Cities were flooded. Any able-bodied person was asked to go out and put sandbags around the houses. So it was a terrible time. It was a 500 or 1,000-year flood. Only problem was, the next year, 1994, they had another one, almost equal to or greater than the one we had. So as you think about famines and floods, it's not just a thing of Old Testament times. We do have those kind of issues come up around the world, as you well remember. Job 12:15 says, "Drought comes when God withholds rain. Floods come when he turns water loose." Psalm 33:18-19, "Behold, the eye of the Lord is on those who fear him, on those who hope in his mercy, to deliver them from soul from death, and to keep them alive in famine. Your famine may have caused you to feel like you're going to the end, but you won't. God promises to keep you alive in famine." There's a song that came to my mind also as we listened to Justin, and it's called "Stand By Me." It's a gospel song written and performed by Elvis Presley. I've asked Josh Newby, our music director here at the church, to do that song now, accompany himself on the guitar. So Josh, take it away. Thanks, folks. See you next time. Bye-bye.
When the storms of life are raging, stand by me. When the storms of life are raging, stand by me. When the world is tossing like a ship out on the sea, thou who rulest wind and water, stand by me. When I'm growing old and feeble, stand by me. When I'm growing old and feeble, stand by me. When I do the best I can, and my friends misunderstand, thou who never lost a battle, stand by me. Thou who never lost a battle, stand by me.